election.
Political analyst John Dadian joins us here this morning now to talk about the upcoming debate and where the election kind of appears to be headed at this point. What are the critical issues here that we're talking about, John?
Well, the first big issue, and Heather made the comment that both are, you know, evenly as far as favorability. So the real big issue is they're not Filner. I mean, everybody, the polls are showing that they want ethics, they want that type of thing. So that really.
Did the voters just suddenly change their minds?
Well,
or did they not realize what they were getting with Bob Filner?
Of course, they didn't realize what they were getting. But to answer your question directly, the big issues are Kevin Faulkner saying he's the business candidate, and David Alvarez is saying he's the one who's going to empower the neighborhoods. Very similar to a Bob Filner type philosophy. What David Alvarez is doing is he's taking the progressive Filner philosophy without all the Filner baggage. That's what a lot of people voted for, so that's why he's attracting a lot of
Talk about the two recent polls, though, because it wasn't too long ago that we talked about a poll that Kevin Faulkner had a substantial lead, and now this latest poll comes out and shows the two neck and neck.
You know, polls are nothing more than a snapshot in time, and both these polls had different methodologies, you know, whether or not there were robocalls, whether or not they had push questions and all that. So I quite honestly, my gut tells me there's no doubt in my mind that today and on election day it's going to be just a very close race. I don't think you're going to see a big blowout.
Who would shake things up the most? Who would be more status quo? Who would be the one that would be likely to institute changes in San Diego from the way business is being done now?
Again, probably neither, because they're on a platform of this. Todd Gloria has done a great job as interim mayor, so let's keep that going is basically what both the philosophy is. But Kevin Faulkner, keep in mind, Kevin Faulkner is supporting this referendum that's going against the city council vote, so he's trying to say, I would help business more.
I've noticed with these past few months that we've gone down to now two candidates. The special election is just a few days, if not weeks, away from right now. It's been very quiet. This debate has been very mild, or I should say contest has been very mild-mannered. The most recent debate that the two candidates took part in, it got a little more testy. Do you expect things like that to happen again this Saturday when I moderate the debate that will again air on Sunday? Or do you think it will just remain all calm on the Western Front, if you will?
No, I think it will get a little bit more exciting when you moderate the debate on this weekend. And I think you've seen that just very slightly, but I think you've seen it, that they've been a little bit more pointed to each other. One thing you want to watch for this weekend, Heather, is when you ask a question, you'll notice the last couple of debates, it's the oldest trick. They answer the question they want to answer. So it's going to be very hard to keep them on track. And you'll notice they'll be turning to each other and doing pointed questions no matter what the moderator just asked.
So that's the tip. When you ask the question, then listen for the answer, and if you don't hear it, say, okay, that's great, but now the question I asked was...
famous phrase is hold their feet to the fire.
Well, yeah, and I think that we've talked about that a little bit, is getting them to actually answer the question that was just asked. Unfortunately, with some of the debates that we've seen due to their time restrictions and whatnot, they weren't answering the questions. And I thought, you know, the viewers, the voters, they want to hear the answers, because I think in the past what we've seen is a candidate get elected and all I saw from Bob Filner during the debates was slamming his opponent and never answering a thing. So let's try to get answers out of these gentlemen on Saturday, which again airs Sunday.
Easier said than done.
John Tadian, thanks.
They're dealing with me though, John. I've got two babies at home.
Oh, hey, John,
why do you think I won't run for office? I don't want to be grown.
Before I let you go, read that line right there.
Now pitching for the Padres and hitting ninth, number 54, Alex Torres.
All right, we'll put you on the list. John
Dadian.
Auditioning, okay. Thanks, John.
Analyst.